This is a production of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, made possible by the Friends of SDPB. Pledge your support for quality programming. Call Friends at 800-333-0789 or donate online at sdpb.org. You may purchase this video and many others online at our website. Click on Shop SDPB. And thank you.
This high school activities championship event is conducted under the auspices of the South Dakota High School Activities Association.
And good afternoon, South Dakota, and welcome to the beautiful Rushmore Plaza Civic Center with Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, 1230 KWSN. I'm Mike Henriksen from Calling All Sports and Sportsmax Radio. Craig, it seems like just a few days ago, you and I were sitting courtside up in Huron. We had the whole South Dakota Public Broadcasting crew put together. This should be a great, fun tournament to broadcast this weekend.
This is going to be a very competitive tournament. Just because you're a number one or a number two or a number three seed does not mean that you're going to get to the championship game. There's a tough road to hoe for all of these eight teams.
Yeah, no question. This is a very, very balanced tournament. O'Gorman comes in as the two-time defending state champs, but again, they will be taking on Rapid City Central to start our tournament, and Rapid City Central played them tough earlier this year. Let's take a look at the information for the Rapid City Central Cobblers.
Third straight appearance to the state tournament.
And Mike Purcell is the head coach. He is in his seventh year. Cody Harris leads the way scoring-wise. Robert Connett is the leading rebounder, and Jake Lewis leads in assists. Now, a reminder, in AA basketball, in the postseason, you have to win two before you lose two. So, consequently, you'll see some of these teams that picked up two wins, and that's what Rapid City Central did. They defeated Sturgis Brown High School, and then they defeated Rapid City Stevens by four to move to the state tournament. So they got two victories. Some of these teams you'll see had a win, then a loss, then a win. But in Rapid City Central, they ended up with the district title. Jake Lewis, Cody Harris, Robert Connett, Ian Bars, and Ryan Leese are the starters. Good size across that entire lineup, Craig. And Cody Harris is one of those kids that's going to be fun to watch this year.
There's the head coach, Mike Purcell. He's in his seventh year for Rapid City Central.
Meanwhile, let's take a look at the O'Gorman Knights. The O'Gorman Knights, coached by Derek Roby, graduate of Northern State University.
Two-time defending champs. This is their fourth straight appearance to the AA tournament.
Connor Schaefbauer is the leading scorer and leads in assists. Nick Mimick is the leading rebounder. But the key really to this team, Craig, all season long has been their balance. They don't have a bunch of kids that are going to be going off playing college basketball like they've had the last couple of years. There you see their road to Rapid City. They defeated Watertown 62-41.
They looked really good in the district. Saw both those games. O'Gorman played real well. Remember, they lost their last regular season game to Sioux Falls, Washington. And Connor Schaefbauer is the key. If Connor has a great game, that's where the Knights are going to go. He's averaging more than 20 points a game.
And there you take a look. Not great size, but again, balance. Schaefbauer and Riedel in the backcourt. Nick Mimick, Sam Wallen, and Tyler Pals are the starters across the front line. And Craig, this is an O'Gorman lineup that really, there's a good look at Derek Roby.
Seventh year.
And he's had one successful run in his time at O'Gorman. Four state titles?
Yep, they've been in the state finals six times over the last 8 years. They're the two-time defending champs.
But what we will see from O'Gorman is these are kids who, you know, they lost Cedric Lang and they lost Keaton Moffitt and some of those kids. But some of these guys have been waiting their turn and have stepped into the role of starters and have performed very well.
Well, Schaefbauer was their quarterback for football, and he's the quarterback as well for the basketball team. And he is a fun kid to watch.
And we want to congratulate all of our officials who are doing these state tournaments this weekend, too. Very nice honor for those gentlemen, and certainly well-deserved. Let's get things started from the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center and send it over to our good buddy, the Golden Voice, Kevin Phillips.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. The South Dakota High School Activities Association, along with its corporate partners, Sanford Health, First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Farmers Union Insurance, Billion Automotive, and the South Dakota Army National Guard welcome you to the opening session of the State Boys High School Basketball Tournament. This tournament is being conducted under the guidance and regulation of the South Dakota High School Activities Association for the enjoyment and benefit of high school students. Good sportsmanship is essential for the success of these programs. We hope you'll enjoy the games and support your athletes in a positive and sportsmanlike manner. Be a sport and support good sportsmanship. Our first game today features the Rapid City Central Cobblers and the Sioux Falls O'Gorman Knights. Let's start by introducing the cheerleaders. Cheering for Rapid City today, Cassidy Muller, Kate Bingen, Sydney Harrison, Michaela Frederick, Takia Snipes, Bailey Const, Jason Fuentes, Yero Delanusis, Marissa Hall, Cameron Barber, Maverick Greyhorse, Cobbler cheer coach Cassie Brewer. Cheering today for the O'Gorman Knights, Ariane Assan, Annabella Gilbert, Allison Hasvold, Amanda Keck, Teresa Lanen, Maggie Laudenschlager, Molly Millage, Lindsay Spencer, cheer coach Molly W. Christensen. Now let's introduce the teams. The players for Rapid City Central. Number 3, Jake Seals. Number 11, Asher Pakula. Number 12, Christian Beckler. Number 20, Chance Taken. Number 21, Jesse Riddle. Number 22, John Fierro. Number 23, Greg Schaefer. Number 30, Trevor Lorenz. Number 31, Nathan Miller. And number 45, Mitchell Newhouse. Let's meet the players for Sioux Falls O'Gorman. Number 3, Jaden Holzer. Number 5, Tanner Schulte. Number 10, Nick Messler. Number 15, Jake Rogers. Number 20, Ryan Lindberg. Number 22, Max Donahue. Number 24, Connor Nagel. Number 30, Kyle Skulton. Number 34, Spencer Hopkins. Number 42, Tommy Entwistle. Now let's introduce the starting lineups for both teams. For the Cobblers, at guard, a 6-foot senior, number 4, Jake Lewis. For the Knights, at guard, a 6-foot senior, number 4, Connor Schaefbauer. Starting for Rapid City at a forward, a 6'3 senior, number 14, Ryan Lees. For O'Gorman at guard, a 6'1 senior, number 31, Austin Riedel. For the Cobblers at forward, a 6'5 junior, number 24, Ian Barse. For the Knights at forward, a 6'3 senior, number 33, Sam Wallen. For Rapid City at forward, a 6'4 senior, number 35, Cody Harris. For the Knights at forward, a 6'2 junior, number 35, Tyler Pals. for the Cobblers at center, a 6'6 senior, number 42, Robert Connett. And for the Knights at forward, a 6'2 senior, number 44, Nick Mimick. Head coach for the Cobblers, Mike Purcell, assisted by Steve Anderson, Keith Holzer, Chris Clark, and Jeff Wimp. Head coach for the Knights, Derek Roby, assisted by Steve Creer, B.J. Keppen, Blake Bradfield, Mike Newfield, and Rob Burns. Now at this time, ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand as we honor America? Join in the singing of our national anthem. It'll be played by the Newell High School Band under the direction of Marty Jump. We remind all in attendance, proper respect is to remove your cap, face the flag, please turn off your cell phones, and stand at attention with your right hand over your heart. Veterans in active duty military not in uniform may salute the flag. Colors being presented by the Central High School Junior ROTC Color Guard. Color Guard members Josh Trimble, Tristan Janice, Katie Layton, David Karski. ROTC advisor Major Connolly. Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem. Thank you. Quick reminder for all cheer coaches and cheerleaders.
Craig, we want to wish a special thank you to the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center. They have provided us with the nicest chairs we have ever gotten in the history of state tournaments. This is great. We always appreciate coming out, the hospitality that everyone has out here, and it should be a terrific tournament. Also want to give a special shout out to our good friend Bob Laskowski, longtime Rapid City native who is watching online at sdpb.org. And a reminder that you can watch all of the tournaments, all 12 games from all three locations, online at sdpb.org. Craig, key to this game?
Well, this is the third time these two teams have met. O'Gorman has won both, but back in January, the last time they met, it was only a seven-point ball game. O'Gorman will try to go more of a half-court offense. We'll see what Central, if they want to make this an up-tempo type game.
And Jake Lewis will bring it into the front court. Knights come out straight up, man-to-man. Lewis, the pick and roll, gets it inside to Connett, tipped away, and controlled by the Knights. One possession, one turnover. Here come the Knights, and we've got a whistle on the clock. Yep. Resetting the shot clock. Good piece of officiating there by Levi Pearson.
You know, the Knights will up-tempo if they have the numbers. If they don't have the numbers, they'll bring it back and set up the offense and wait for the good shot. But Schaefbauer now with the ball, 16 points a game. He is the court leader out there.
He is heading off to the University of Minnesota to play baseball next year. Outstanding player for the Sioux Falls Legion team. working that right side is Riedel. Riedel, they'll get it inside the layup, up and good by Nick Mimic. The 6'2 senior gives the O'Gorman Knights a lead here in the early going. Again, a reminder, if you were with us on SDPB1 last week and saw the Girls B tournament, and there's an unforced error as the player cut on the left side and the ball thrown away. There was no shot clock. Well, with AA boys, there is a shot clock, so that is what you see right there above the sdpb.org. That is the shot clock, a 35-second shot clock to shoot the ball in AA basketball.
Cobblers have to limit turnovers. They have to be able to keep the ball. Almost like a football analogy, they need to keep the ball more than O'Gorman.
Schaefauer came up well short, and the rebound controlled by the Cobblers.
Looking forward to watching Cody Harris. He's the real deal here for the Cobblers. He wears number 35, now has the ball.
They get it to him this time, but he'll give it up over to Lees. Ryan Lees gives it back over to Ian Barse. The pull up in the lane, no good. Barse gets his own rebound, has it stripped away, and the Knights with the ball and the lead. Here in the early going, O'Gorman on top. The number one seed in this tournament, the two-time defending state champion. The drive along the baseline by Riedel by Mimic is no good.
Good offense. Good defensive rebound by Connett.
Absolutely. Here come the Cobblers.
Connett is 6'6". He's the tallest player on the floor.
There's the floater up off glass. Too strong. Great move, though, by Harris. But the Knights with the defensive board. On the left wing, over it goes to Wallen.
You know, Mike, some of these O'Gorman Knights players really were major players when they won the title here 2 years ago.
The floater by Harris up and good.
Finger roll.
Great gather by Cody Harris. Tied at two apiece as we near the five-minute mark.
You know, Central plays a few games here during the season. They're a little more used to the arena.
Pull-up jumper by Schaefauer is good, and O'Gorman takes the lead back. Into the front court, there comes Jake Lewis. In the background, the coach is calling out the play. Saluki, an Illinois State fan, no doubt. The cutter, top of the key, the three on the way is an air ball. It goes out of bounds, and it will turn over to the O'Gorman Knights.
There's a nice shot of Coach Purcell. See, just relax is what he's telling his players.
Some token pressure here by the Cobblers. Now the trap in the front court. Giving it up over to Riedel. Back out, Schaefauer, the floater in the lane, got it. Connor Schaefauer with his second bucket of the day. It's a four-point lead for the Knights.
Cobblers have to prevent that from happening. They can't let Schaefauer come down the lane. He is so dangerous coming down the lane, doing the old dribble drive, maybe kicking it out to somebody along the wing.
Ryan Lees gives it up to Barsh. Barsh tries to shake his man. Good man-to-man defense by Tyler Pals. The pull-up jumper on the left wing by Harris, up and good for three. Cody Harris with all 5 points here in the early going. Bro Gorman into the front court. The drive in the lane, the step through, the layup, up and good as Sam Wallen, the 6'3 senior. He's heading off to play college football next year. He was one of those kids that, when he was a freshman, Craig, a lot of folks thought his future was in basketball, was a terrific player as a freshman, but hasn't grown any and decided that football is where his best future was. The pull out, the long three by Harris, no good. The tip, the put back, and we've got a foul whistle. That'll be our first of the game. Jeff Schaefer with the call. Sam Wallen will pick up the foul, and stepping up to the free throw line is Ryan Lees.
Looking right into the O'Gorman student section.
Got that one.
And tonight's number 20, Ryan.
Averages 57% from the free throw line.
Knights bring in Kyle Schulten and Ryan Lindberg.
Yeah, the Knights, that's their typical rotation. Lindberg and Skolton come in.
The second free throw to make it a one-point game is good as well, and we'll step aside. A good one to tip off our AA coverage in Rapid City on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, 1230 KWSN, I'm Mike Henriksen from Calling All Sports and Sportsmax Radio. The O'Gorman Knights, number one seed, holding on to the one-point lead here in the early going.
Here comes that half-court trap by the Cobblers. Spolton. Knights, though, do a pretty good job holding on to the ball. They're only averaging 9 turnovers a game.
Working the perimeter against the zone defense by the Cobblers as they'll settle back in.
Lindbergh, their number one three-point shooter.
Schaefbauer, the pull-up, front of the rim, no. Lindbergh runs down the long rebound. Ball tipped away. And the Knights will control. Reset on the shot clock.
Pretty good zone defense here by the Cobblers.
Absolutely. They're
staying
doing a nice job.
On the outside.
Into the lane. Schaefbauer was cut off. They will find the cutter. The ball is knocked out of bounds and last touch by the Knights. Nice inside defense by Robert Connett.
Knights with a little pressure. They don't.
Into the front court. Here comes Rapid City Central. On the dribble. That's Barsh. He'll give it back to Lewis. To Harris, who has 5 in the early going. Down low to Connick, the post up, the fall away, he got it.
That is a great matchup between Connick, and Mimic. That time Connick with a nice move in the lane with the right-handed floater.
Again, the size advantage goes to the Cobblers, and they've got the early lead here as the number 8 seed. The pull-up jumper, the kiss off the glass, up and good by Ryan Lindbergh, the 6'2 senior. Another one of those kids, Craig, that we talked about, waited his turn with the program and has been a big contributor this year in his senior year.
Any shot that comes off the window, I like.
I'm with you.
Even when they're beyond the three-point arc.
That's right. There's the three up by Harris. No good. And a rebound foul whistle. That is going to go on Rapid City Central. Foul goes on Ryan Lees. That will be his first personal and the first team foul as well. O'Gorman with the lead back. Good crowd on hand for a Thursday afternoon. Of course, the place will continue to fill up during the course of the day. Some really fun matchups in this tournament.
Oh, yeah.
And wide open. Schaefbauer down the lane, double pumps, up off glass, no good. Rebound controlled by Lindbergh. He'll bring it back out, reset the offense. Mimic puts it on the floor, and he draws the foul from Connett. So Robert Connett will pick up the foul. That will be the second team foul. As back into the rotation is Sam Wallen and Tyler Pals.
That's the rotation the Knights will do all day. They only run about 7 players.
Meanwhile, Rapid City Central has brought John Fierro, a 5'11 junior guard, off of the bench.
Yeah, they don't go very deep either.
There's the drive up, no good. Connick kept it alive, and it's controlled by Tyler Pals. Pals goes out to Lindbergh. Schaefbauer gives it up. Nice defense inside by the Cobblers. And Knights have to reset with 20 now on the shot clock.
Yeah, Fierro doing a great job down in the low block. He's trying to guard Tyler Pals.
Mimic, the spin. Connett didn't leave his feet. Good move defensively by Connett, but a nice offensive shot by Mimic. Up and good, and O'Gorman with that 12-9 lead. Central led it 9-8.
Well, Connett got the score over Mimic last time they had the ball. This last time, Mimic returned the favor.
Harris has his pass tipped away, out of bounds. 4-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Over the course of the years, Derek Roby has been known to be a guy who works the clock. As a matter of fact, there were times before the shot clock, the final minute and a half or so, he'd run off. Jumper, Wallen, got it. Sam Wallen, the 6'3 senior with the bucket. And it's a 6-0 run by O'Gorman during this quarter.
Well, the Cobblers have won five games in a row coming into this first state tournament game.
Lees goes behind the back, tries to shake the defender. Now better get out of the lane. He does. You see the time, the pull up. Harris, short, rebound, controlled by O'Gorman, and a foul with 0.8 seconds left.
Yeah, Fierro is going to get called for the push.
John, the 5'11 junior. And O'Gorman will inbound the ball and will be at the end of the quarter. As checking into the lineup is
Skolten.
Yeah, Kyle Skolten, the 6'3 junior, comes back in for 0.8 seconds, and that'll do it. At the end of one, O'Gorman on top, 14-8. We're back after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Along with Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. O'Gorman on top of Central, 14-9.
Hey, they're just about done with the first quarter up in Aberdeen. Number one, White River leading Castlewood 19-2 with 90 seconds to go in the first quarter.
Wow.
White River's been so strong. Their only loss was to Class A's St. Thomas More.
Last game of the regular season. Otherwise, they've been outscoring people by 40 a game. Again, you can watch all of the action on all three South Dakota Public Broadcasting channels or on certain cable channels. And you can go online at sdpb.org. The tip away. Nice defensive back type play there by Austin Riedel.
Cobbler's got to limit those turnovers. They've got four of them already here in the game.
Pull-up jumper was an air ball, but
Wallen now with 6 points.
And it is a 8-0 run. An 8-0 run, in case any of my English teachers are tuning in this afternoon. For O'Gorman, they trailed it 9-8. The drive, Harris, offensive foul, wave off the basket. Standing in to take the charge was Nick Mimic. Good team help defense by the O'Gorman Knights. And Craig, that's one of the things. With all of the talent that they have had through the years, the Knights have always played good team help defense.
They play a lot of man-to-man. You know, they'll play some zone, but really they like that man-to-man defense. Steve Creer, of course, an assistant coach, he loves that man-to-man as well. You know, the Central Cobbler defense hasn't been that bad. O'Gorman has just had some good shots that they've sunk, but so far I like that 2-3 zone they've played so far.
They have done a nice job of limiting O'Gorman. Again, coming up later on today, we've got some very intriguing matchups. You can follow along on all of the high school activities at sdpb.org.
In that Class A tournament, number one St. Thomas More is down to Tri-Valley. Tri-Valley leading St. Thomas More 22-18, a couple of minutes into the second quarter.
Again, that's another tournament that is wide open. Tri-Valley is very, very solid and very athletic. We are in the second quarter as O'Gorman leads Rapid City Central. In the lane, Mimic. Jumper, wave it off. Offensive foul. Foul is going on Sam Wallen.
Good look at it right here, coming right down the lane.
And, yep.
And Sam will do that. Wallen, very aggressive coming down the lane. But good defense by the Cobblers taking the charge. That's always not the easiest thing to do, Mike, standing there waiting for you to be taken care of there.
Especially when it's Sam Wallen. He is full grown into the front court. Here comes Rapid City Central. Lewis gives it up to Cody Harris. Harris back to Barsh. The jumper for three up and good.
Nice front looking look.
Ian Varsh, the 6'5 junior, buries the three. That stops the O'Gorman run. And there's the drive by Schaefbauer. No good. Connett with the rebound. Off to Lewis. Jake into the front court. Varsh on the dribble. Now gives it back to Lewis. Can't really be in the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center and hear the last name Lewis without thinking of Randy Lewis, the world-class wrestler. Shot no good. The rebound, the outlet, the run out by Schaefbauer, up and good.
Nick Mimic very aware after he got that rebound. He saw Schaefbauer taken off. Big assist by Mimic.
Jake Lewis into the front court, gives it up to Barsh. Gives it back to Harris. Harris, the follow-away jumper in the lane. That's a tough shot off glass. You know, I have not had a chance to see Rapid City Central play this year. I had heard that he's an explosive player. Boy, he's been fun to watch in the early going. Schaefbauer, no good. Rebound, Connett. He'll clear it to Lewis. And here comes Central looking to cut into that lead again.
Well, Harris has 7 points. Give it to the guy who's hot.
He's got it out near midcourt, being covered by Austin Riedel. Lewis, they tried the pick and roll instead, cross court. Over to Cody Harris, 6'4" and a senior. The steal, Schaefbauer, the run out, layup good. Craig, you talked about turnovers, and that's really been the difference in this game so far. Is
Connor just wishes he was about 2 inches taller. He could maybe dunk it there.
The defensive anticipation, the quick hands. Lewis into the front court. Gives it up to Barsh. Working that perimeter against man-to-man defense by the Knights. Down low to Connick. Connick gets away from his man, puts it up. He's fouled. He'll step to the line and shoot two.
Austin Riedel is going to get called for the foul. Tried to block it from behind.
Fouls on 31.
That will be his first personal foul, the third team foul on O'Gorman. And Robert Connett steps up to the line, 55% free throw shooter, and he buries that one. Ryan Lees will come back into the lineup, and Cody Harris will take a breather. Also in is John Fierro back into the lineup, and taking a chair is Greg Schaefer. Greg, kind of a unique story. His brother plays for Stevens. And their dad was from Pierre, Troy Schaefer. Second free throw is no good, and O'Gorman will control. I'm going to be talking a lot about Troy Schaefer, and I apologize if it sounds like a man crush, but he was one of my favorite all-time players when he was a Pierre governor back in the early 80s. Schaefbauer on the dribble, lost the handle, got it back. Man-to-man defense now being played by the Cobblers. 7 on the shot clock, reverse it. Schaefbauer skips over the rim, no good. Weak side rebound, put up, no good. Rebound knocked out of bounds, and we'll step aside. O'Gorman on top of Central, and we're back after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock from Sports Radio KWSN in Sioux Falls, I'm Mike Henriksen from Calling All Sports, heard on 8 radio stations across eastern South Dakota. On behalf of the whole crew that we've got working for you today on South Dakota Public Broadcasting, you know, bringing all 12 games from all 3 locations, it is literally all hands on deck, and we greatly appreciate the crew that has been assembled at all 3 locations this weekend. Working that perimeter again against man-to-man defense, and we're going to have a foul on the reach-in.
Yeah, Fierro will get called for the reach-in foul. That would be his second.
So it will belong to the Knights in their own front court. Derek Roby and the staff of the O'Gorman Knights. And away from the ball, Fierro tying his shoe. Now we're set to go.
Well, Leese is the one that's going to be on Schaefauer. Sometimes they've been switching on their picks, but Reese pretty much going wherever Schaefauer goes.
Nice. Cut inside, layup by Pals, assist to Wallen. And O'Gorman with the 7-point lead.
Ties the biggest lead of the game.
They trailed 9-8. Central got off to a nice start. The entry pass down to Connett. He'll put it up too strong. Got its own rebound. Muscles it back. One more time. Oh, he just can't get it to go. But what an effort by Robert Connett.
Trying to jam it home twice. Couldn't quite do it because of the pressure.
Take a look
good
at the
offensive rebound.
Yeah, the hard work by Mr. Connett.
Pals with his first foul.
That is the fourth team foul. Connett now 2 for 3 at the free throw line, a 55% shooter on the season.
You want this guy touching the ball on every offensive possession.
Second one on the way. That one's good. He's 3 for 4 at the line. Speaking of touching the ball in every possession, Cody Harris will check back into the lineup.
Shot clock is not working again. They'll run some time off a shot clock.
And that will allow Harris the opportunity to come into the ball game.
Even though this is the third time these two teams have played this year, Mike, it was the first weekend of the year back in December, and again the first weekend in January when they met.
So it has been plenty of time. Knights able to break the pressure. Schaefauer, the great feed underneath, and Barsh with the foul. He tried to make sure that Mimic wasn't going to get the ball up in the air.
Well, he got caught up in the air, and as an offensive player, you're always taught to go ahead and lead into that jumper if they're up in the air, and two shots coming from Mimic.
For Barsh, that is his first personal. Mimic buries that one. Nick on the year.
There's the shot. Yep, got him up in the air and lean right into him, and two free throws coming.
Nick shoots less than 50% at the free throw line. That one just boiled out. He's got good form. That first one was perfect. That one just rattled out. Some of these kids, you look at them, and it's easy to see why they don't shoot very well at the free throw line. That's not the case with Nick.
Harris with the basketball. Gives it up to Barsh. Again, Central, the number 8 seed, hanging tough. Great feed into Connett. Wonderful assist by Ian Barsh.
And again, it's down to a 4-point game. Into the front court, Tyler Pals. He'll give it up on the right side over to Riedel. Now to Schaefauer and to Lindberg. Central. Can't tell if they're in zone or man-to-man because O'Gorman isn't moving very much. Schaefauer gives it up.
They're sticking man-to-man here,
yep.
Mike.
Shot clock. Down in single digits, the shot no good. Rebound battled for. Mimic came up with it, puts it up no good. Rebound knocked out of bounds. Last touch by the Knights of O'Gorman. Great job inside of hustling on the defensive boards by the Cobblers.
Yeah, Cody Harris almost tipped that one off of Tyler Pals and it went out of bounds.
So let's see if Central can get even closer. Again, they led it 9-8. They have trailed by 7. Lewis into the front court. He'll use the high screen. Again, man-to-man defense by the Knights. They've been man-to-man throughout the first half.
Again, they're looking for Connett down low.
Barsh.
Trying to get him the ball. Mimic is trying to front him, though, every time they may be trying to pass the ball to him.
Now they find him. Great entry pass in by Harris. A 2-point game. O'Gorman will not be able to hold for the last shot.
Connett's got 9.
He has had a terrific first half. Into the front court. Here come the Knights. The step through. The feed right side. Great ball movement by O'Gorman to beat the half court pressure.
Boy, we've seen some great passes from both teams opening quarter of the tournament.
Now, Ian Barsh, the 6'5 junior, will start it. Lewis gives it up. Out top to Harris. Cody Harris, the 6'4 senior, to Connett. Back to Harris.
the feed. Fall away, no good. Rebound pulled down by Mimic. Here comes O'Gorman. It's good if it goes. No. At halftime, the O'Gorman Knights are on top, 25-21. The number one seed has their hands full against the number eight seed in our opening game from the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center. We're back with more after this timeout. You're watching the boys' AA state tournament on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Dakota Bank, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Farmers Union Insurance.
Back at the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center, how's about a little entertainment this afternoon?
Please welcome to the floor Rapid City Central Cobbler Co-Eds and advisor Casey Darrow. Ladies and gentlemen, the Cobbler Coeds.
You want some of this?
Impressive. Yes, sir. Let's get it on. You want to start something? You want to start something?
Central High School Cobbler Coeds.
At halftime, the O'Gorman Knights on top of the Rapid City Central Cobblers, 25-21. We're back to Rushmore Plaza Civic Center after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Along with Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, 1230 KWSN. I'm Mike Henriksen from Calling All Sports and SportsMax Radio. Along with the whole crew from South Dakota Public Broadcasting, we are delighted to have you joining us for this boys AA tournament from the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center. At halftime, the O'Gorman Knights on top of the Rapid City Central Cobblers. Knights, two-time defending champs and top seed in this tournament. Take a look at some of the highlights. In the early going, got the block on Connett.
But then a nice move inside by Nick Mimic. He's able to score off the glass. The cutter's inside, but then the pull-up jumper by Sam Wallen. That's up and good. The offensive foul by Wallen. A good job defensively there by Cody Harris. Then the long three by Barsh. That's up and good. The run out by Schaefbauer. He had a couple of those. Here comes Harris. The floater off glass. Up and good. And then another run out by Connor Schaefbauer. And at halftime, up inside one more time. Up and good. As the foul inside by Barsh. And then Connett, Robert did a great job inside. He leads the way for the Cobblers at halftime. Another bucket by Mimic. An awful lot of points scored inside. Craig Maddock, who joins us back here at the desk, as inside the Cobblers were very effective getting the ball inside to Robert Connett.
That's the guy I want to beat.
And so it was O'Gorman who trailed actually 9-8 at one point. But they have led by as many as 7. And we are at halftime. O'Gorman taking on Rapid City Central. See Gary Munson across the way. He's in the building. We'll be talking an awful lot about his quest as the legendary coach is stepping down at the end of this tournament as head coach of the Mitchell Colonels. Some Natalie attired fans here at the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center. A good crowd for a Thursday afternoon. As we said, a lot of folks arriving in town this afternoon. Craig, isn't life easy when the weather has been as good as it has to travel across the state to come to this event?
Oh, yeah. We've been stuck in a few locations for a few extra days. Weather's great. Big key. I like Rapid City Central in their defense in that first half. I think we'll see if they continue to come out in that man-to-man or if they go zone. But
yeah, they mixed it up a little. Straight man-to-man. Meanwhile, the pull-up jumper by Harris for three, up and good. It's a one-point game.
He's got 10 points. He's the hot guy.
He and Connett have combined for 19 of the 24 Central points. Rapid City Central extending that defense. The weak side. Pull-up. Nope. Instead, the drive and a rebound foul whistled as hitting the boards was Ryan Leese, and a foul going to be whistled. That's going to go on Nick Mimic. Nick will pick up his first team foul this half. Again, the number 8 seed, Rapid City Central, can take the lead here. It would be the second time that they have led in the ballgame.
This tempo here fits Rapid City Central to a T.
Jake Lewis comes into the front court, gives it up to Cody Harris, the 6'4 senior. Down low, Connett in the lane, no good, but he'll step to the line and shoot two.
That is a great battle right there with Mimic and Connett. Cobblers, no doubt about it, going to Connett, and they want to challenge Mimic in the paint.
Connett will step to the free throw line. That one is up and short.
4 minutes left in the third quarter, St. Thomas.
Connett is a 55% free throw shooter.
There's that entry pass to Connett, and I think we'll see that play a lot.
That one is no good. He goes 0 for 2, and the rebound pulled down by Tyler Powles. Ahead to Schaefbauer. Schaefbauer. Reversing the basketball, looking for cutters inside. Now back to Schaefbauer.
Cobblers going with that zone.
Austin
Riedel. Putting Leese and Barsh there in the front, the quickest players.
Cobblers with size as far as height goes, but also some long arms there extending that zone. Schaefbauer, the pull-up, no good. The double bounce threw off a couple of rebounders and a nice rebound by Ian Barsh.
Cobblers have never led this game. It was tied at 2.
No, they did lead it 9-8.
Oh, that's right, 9-8.
Then it was a 8-0 run, an 8-0 run by O'Gorman that got them up ahead. Ball tipped away. Lewis gets it back. Double pumps. Puts it up. No good. And the rebound, Nick Mimic.
Rebound battle is won by O'Gorman so far, 17-12.
Against the zone defense. Again, Rapid City Central changed up a couple of times in that first half.
The kick back out. If you're wondering what that gray line is, the pull-up jumper by Schaefbauer, up and good. He got into the heart of the zone and scored it. That is the professional three-point line. In high school, they have to shoot from outside of the white area.
Well, they don't have many of those games out here in Rapid City anymore.
No, they don't. That was an investment in paint that didn't quite pay off for him.
Good looking court, though.
Oh, it is. It's gorgeous. I love this court. Connett. The jumper by Lewis for three. Too strong. And the weak side rebound pulled down by Tyler Pals. The drive, the shot, no good. Rebound by Connett. He'll give it up to Barsh. O'Gorman is back, and Rapid City Central will bring it into the front court.
Connett with seven rebounds in the game already.
Feed it off to Harris, and we'll step aside. O'Gorman on top of Central, and we're back after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. The number one seed, O'Gorman, doing battle with Rapid City Central, the number eight seed.
The Cobblers have lost to every team here at the state tournament. O'Gorman is 7-2 against the teams here at the tournament. But the Cobblers, they've been playing some good basketball here this afternoon.
Inbound pass against some full court pressure from the Cobblers. Now, O'Gorman will leave it up to Sam Wallen to bring it into the front court. Ball is knocked out of bounds, and it will belong to the Cobblers.
Fifth turnover for O'Gorman. That one they just threw away too far.
Thanks to all of the men and women helping us out behind the scenes here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. A great crew to work with. Craig and I are honored to be part of this group. Central.
Well, I like the way that Harris and Connett play.
I do too.
First time I've seen them too this year, and well, I like the way they play.
Yeah, this is just a pull-up jumper on the way by Barsh for three, up and good, and it's a tie ball game.
I like Barsh too.
There's a lot of things to like about Central this afternoon.
Nice trap half court here by the Cobblers. Again, O'Gorman only averaging 9 turnovers a game.
They take extremely good care of the basketball, but Cobblers really putting some defensive pressure on them. Schaefbauer works it over on the right side. The pull-up jumper in the lane, no good, but the offensive rebound by Mimic.
Oh.
And then he lost the ball out of bounds. So give it back to Central, and they've got a chance to take their second lead of the ball game. They led it 9-8. With a couple of minutes left to go in the first quarter.
Lindbergh is back in for the Knights.
They trailed at 14-9 at the end of one, 25-21 at halftime. Here comes Cody Harris, the 6'4 senior. Man-to-man defense by the Knights out to Jake Lewis. Lewis covered by Connor Schaefbauer. Out top to Harris. Harris being guarded by Austin Riedel. You see the shot clock winding down, now into single digits. Connett with the nice feed, the reverse, up and good. Lease with the bucket, Connett with the assist, and Central with the lead.
And their biggest lead. Oh, and they throw it away again, the Knights throw it away. Battle threw it too far, intended for Lindbergh.
That is not O'Gorman basketball. Take
there's
a look at this.
Pass.
Yep, look at this great pass from Connett to Lease working the baseline. And here comes Rapid City Central with a chance to extend their lead. Lewis on the dribble. Gives it up to Harris, off to Barsh. To Lease, back to Barsh, looking inside to Connett. Barsh will drive, gonna have a foul whistled before the shot. Let's see who the foul goes on.
Number 20, that will go on Ryan Lindberg of O'Gorman. That will be his first. That is the third team foul. Rapid City Central has not committed a foul yet in this half. Or at least they haven't been whistled for one. We'll put it that way. And there's a turnover and then a foul, and we, just as we got it out of our mouth, it is the first foul of the half. That's going to go on Ian Barsh, the 6'5 junior.
Foul's number 24, Ian Barsh.
His second.
First team foul.
Connor Schaefbauer, who's headed to the University of Minnesota to play baseball next year. At the top of the key against his zone defense. The pull-up jumper up, no good by Lindberg, but run down in the corner by Riedel. And O'Gorman will reset with a fresh clock. Pull-up jumper, Schaefbauer, no good. Rebound, controlled by Lease. And Ryan Lease will leave it for Jake Lewis.
O'Gorman shooting 41% from the floor. They're 13 of 31. Rapid City Central's 45% from the floor, 10 of 22.
Ball tipped away, controlled by Riedel to the rack, no good. Weak side rebound, Mimic muscles it up, no good, but draws the foul.
What a save by Riedel. Thought that one was going out of bounds.
Foul will go on Robert Connett, the 6'6 senior will pick
There's
up.
There's the slap right
yep.
there.
If he keeps the hand straight up in the air, he's just fine. The free throw by Mimic is up and good. Mimic at 6'2, but uses what he's got very effectively inside.
It's only the third free throw of the game for the Knights.
Back into the lineup is Tyler Powles for the Knights. Chance to tie the ball game here. And he does.
Third tie of the game. St. Thomas More down by five to Tri-Valley. They're 6.5 minutes to go in the game. The number one seed in trouble at the Class A's in Sioux Falls.
Not so much in trouble at the State B's, correct?
End White of River. Three, White River leading 44-31 over Castlewood.
Oh, Castlewood came back. The three on the way, no good, and the rebound controlled by the Knights. Ryan Lindberg, the 6'2 senior, coming into the front court. He'll set it up at the point, now leave it for Schaefbauer. Working the perimeter. Is this the fourth year of the shot clock, Craig?
I think it's the fourth or fifth.
Yeah. Okay. Time rifles by when you get to be our age, doesn't it? Schaefbauer.
I like it.
Oh, I love it. Jumper, fall away, baseline, no good. Rebound pulled down by Lees. They'll leave it for Cody Harris, and the 6'4 senior will bring it into the front court against Tyler Powles, who now gets the assignment of guarding Harris.
Lease with three rebounds in the game, but Connett's got seven to lead the way for the Cobblers.
Barsh controls, drives on Lindberg, the spin, he'll put it up, no good. Foul on the drive before the shot. That will be the fourth team foul.
That's on Lindberg.
Lindberg with his second personal.
Saw the slap there by Lindberg as Barsh was spinning.
Central to inbound. Gets it into Barsh. To Connett. Connett against Mimic. Off glass. Got it. The lead back to Rapid City Central.
Well, those long 6'6 arms really helped him take a shot that was way to the side. Able to just reach over and kiss it off the window.
O'Gorman, pull-up jumper, Schaefbauer buries it. That kid is money. Tied at 31.
He's got 12.
Into the front court, Harris spins, double team, gives it up, leads at three, no good. We're tied at 31. We've got a dandy to start the boys' AA state tournament in Rapid City on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. The number 8 seed, Rapid City Central Cobblers, tied with the number 1 seed, Sioux Falls O'Gorman Knights. With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. The beautiful Rushmore Plaza Civic Center.
end of three quarters. O'Gorman, 14 of 36 from the floor. That's 38%. 0 for 3 beyond the arc.
Schaefbauer controls. Inside. Now reverse it. And a double dribble.
Eighth turnover on the Knights.
And that was an unforced turnover on Sam Wallen.
Rapid City Central through three quarters. They're shooting 44%. They're 11 of 25. 4 of 11 from beyond the arc.
Cody Harris, the explosive senior for the Rapid City Central Cobblers. Gives it up. Ryan Leese to Connett, who comes outside, and a foul whistled away from the ball.
Sam Wallen's going to pick up his second.
The 6'3 senior plowed through the screen, and that is going to be the fifth team foul on O'Gorman. Rapid City Central has committed just 2 team fouls so far. Inside Connett, he is fouled. He'll step to the line.
Mimic will pick up his third. That was a great entry pass.
Wonderful.
To Connett. Nice little, and then went right to the rack.
So now the 6th team foul from here on out. Oh, Rapid City Central will be shooting 1-1.
3 for 6 from the line today.
That one's no good. He is a 55% free throw shooter.
He's missed 3 in a row.
That's good. Central with the lead back.
A dozen for Connett leads the way for the Cobblers.
He has just 3 in this half, however. He had 9 in the first half. O'Gorman is led by as many as 7. Central is led by as many as 2. Schaefbauer to Mimic along the baseline to Wallen. Back to Schaefbauer, uses the high screen, feeds inside to Mimic. Mimic the double pump, puts it up. Connett made him change it. Ball knocked out of bounds, last touch by Mimic.
Well, I like that Cobbler defense.
I do too.
They've been really aggressive, not allowing too much to come down the paint. Can easily get sucked in and then faked on a jumper, but they've done a pretty good job today. That's why they're in this game.
Ryan Lees gives it back to the point guard, Jake Lewis, the 6-foot senior. Looking for Connett. Connett to the basket with the left hand, no good. Gets his own rebound, put back, foul.
Connett did exactly what you're supposed to do. You get the ball back, go right to the rack. Look how aggressive he's been. He has been fabulous today.
And here's what I love, Greg. He goes towards the basket, as you mentioned. So many kids, especially when they're as thin as Connett, he'll step to the line and shoot 2. They get into the habit of falling back with their shot. That jumper, no good. He'll step to the line and shoot the second. But Connett, again, not real hefty in the upper body, but he takes the ball to the hole just the way you love to see a kid do.
Mike, less than 2 minutes to go at the A's in Sioux Falls, the number one seed. St. Thomas More down by 1 to Tri-Valley.
And 6.5 minutes to go here in the number 8 seed on top of the number 1 seed as well.
And the number 1 seed in Aberdeen, White River with an 11-point lead on Castlewood with 4.5 to go.
They had jumped out, though, to what, a 19-2 lead, was
yes.
it? Okay.
Yeah.
However, that's a low amount of points for White River. They've been averaging about 80 per game. So Rapid City Central, Robert Connett will step to the free throw line to shoot the second.
Both teams with a bunch of timeouts left. So timeouts, strategy, free throws could be huge.
That free throw is perfect, and it's up to a 2-point lead for Central. Some full court pressure once again. More trap defense. Schaefbauer in the backcourt. Now gets it up to Wallen. Back to Schaefbauer. Connor has been the go-to guy all year, averaging 16 points a game. Riedel to Wallen. Wallen will
fall away, give it up, out to Mimic, the jumper, heel of the rim, no good. Knocked around, Barsh runs it down, and the Cobblers with the lead and the ball. And the Rapid City Central fans feeling this with every tick off the clock. They're getting louder and more apprehensive at the same time. The feed, right side, the block from behind, but stepping to the free throw line will be Connett.
Mimic has just picked up his fourth foul.
Cody Harris has not been a factor in the second half, but what a great feed by Harris. Terrific job by that young man of giving the ball up. Connett.
Connett is 5 of 10 from the free throw line, now 6 of 11.
Biggest lead for Central.
...58% from the free throw line for Rapid City Central this afternoon.
Got that one. 35-31. And we've got a foul whistle. Yep.
Cody
Jeff Schaefer right in front of us with the whistle, says with the hands.
Cody Harris picks up his second foul.
That is only the third team foul on Rapid City Central. Central is shooting free throws from here on out. O'Gorman, four fouls away from that happening. Schaefbauer uses the high screen. Cut off defensively by Lees. The defense by the Cobblers has been terrific, but there's a foul on Harris. He was trying to cut through Wallen posting up.
Timing was just a tad late.
Yep. He had the idea. That will be the fourth team foul, and that is his third personal.
Otherwise, again, that zone defense not getting out of their area too much. It's been tough to go inside for the Knights.
Now Central.
Except,
nice move. That ball was halfway down, and Connett with another rebound. It's tipped away.
Lindberg.
And last touch by O'Gorman.
Yeah, Lindberg tried to save it for the Knights. Now the Knights are going to pick up some extra pressure. A lot of times they've been just waiting until the front court, but now the extra pressure by the Knights.
Lewis, the inbound to Harris, gets it back to Jake Lewis, and the 6-foot senior brings it up against Connor Schaefbauer, the 6-foot senior for O'Gorman.
But the Cobblers had, 7-8 turnovers in that first half?
Yep.
They've only had two or three here in the second half.
Barsh, right side. Now reverse it, still looking inside for Connett. Back out to Lewis. Now to Harris. The drive, the kiss. It's a 6-point Rapid City Central lead.
Harris has got a dozen.
Schaefbauer in the corner. The spin, lost the handle. You hear Mike Purcell, the jumper from Lindbergh for three, up and good.
He's their number one three-point shooter, first one of the tournament.
And the timeout taken by the O'Gorman Knights.
Lindbergh with his 15th three of the year. O'Gorman really isn't known as a three-point shooting team either. But Lindbergh, he's their number one three-point shooter and buries the first one.
He's able to get that one to go. So Central is on top of O'Gorman. The number 8 seed with the lead over number 1. Same thing we are seeing at the A tournament. Again, all 12 games from all three locations on SDPB 1, 2, and 3 on certain cable systems and online at sdpb.org.
Yeah, 30 seconds left in that Class A game, and Tri-Valley up by 3.
Into the front court. Lewis works his way past the timeline. Give it up to Ian Barsh.
Central going to work some clock here. Again, the shot clock you see in the right-hand corner, shot clock at AA basketball level.
See how only. The Cobblers can handle the ball here.
Off to Harris. Harris gives it up. Lewis, corner three, got it!
It's his first basket of the game, Mike.
They ran the offense to perfection, and it's back to a six-point lead. Lindbergh the other way. Ball lost, and a foul whistled. And it's going to be an inbounds play.
Fouls on 35.
Inbounds, so we'll step aside. You're watching the boys' AA basketball tournament on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, 1230 KWSN, I'm Mike Henriksen. The Rapid City Central Cobblers, the number 8 seed in the tournament, with the 6-point lead over the O'Gorman Knights. O'Gorman with the basketball. Full court pressure, or the man-to-man pressure on the inbound. Schaefauer, pull up. Off the heel of the rim, but he'll step to the line and shoot two.
Lease will pick up his second foul.
And that will be the sixth team foul. And so from here on out, both teams are shooting the bonus. Oh. Free throw by Schaefauer, no good.
He's a 74% shooter. That one was halfway down and came out. Only the fifth free throw of the game for the Knights.
Got that one to fall. Marsh turns it over. Schaefauer, no good. Foul. Schaefauer to the line. Foul is going to go on Jake Lewis. And checking back into the lineup will be Cody Harris. Mike Purcell, the coach of the Rapid City Central Cobblers, had him on the bench during the defensive stand. Fierro will come out of the ball game.
It's a final in the B's. White River, the number one seed, advances. They beat Castlewood today 54-33.
Second free throw, good. So three quick points here to cut that lead in half following a couple of central turnovers.
The other two number one seeds, though, in trouble this afternoon.
Lewis, better give it up. Gonna have a 5-second call. Now he does. Good job by Lewis. And he'll bring it back out. You can be called for not advancing the ball if you're tightly guarded.
Uh-oh.
And there's a turnover. Rapid City Central turning the ball over their last couple of games, a shot or a possessions, a shot, and a foul.
Barris has picked up his third. And everyone's shooting free throws from now on, Mike.
Yep. There's Barsh. He had thrown the ball away and tries to get it back. Again, it was 34, just a few seconds ago. O'Gorman making time at the free throw line, and Mike Purcell once and gets a timeout. Again, O'Gorman, two-time defending state champions, an awful lot of new faces on this, but they have been in some pressure-packed games before. Rapid City Central with just 9 wins on the season, and the majority of those, as a matter of fact, I believe all of them, Craig, didn't they come against Douglas Central and Spearfish?
Mm-hmm. You are correct.
Douglas Central and Sturgis, excuse me.
You're still correct.
Okay. Out in Sioux Falls, the A tournament is off to a terrific start. Looking for an update on that, but Tri-Valley did have the 3-point lead. Del Rapids plays winner in the next game. I'm willing to bet, Craig, that there are an awful lot of Del Rapids Courier fans that are cheering for Tri-Valley, many of them perhaps for the first time in their life.
You love to see that number one seed go down.
It's going to overtime in Sioux Falls. Sky Warwick hits a three-pointer at the buzzer to send the game of Tri-Valley into overtime at 55.
Anyone who has watched Sky Warwick play basketball, that is no surprise whatsoever. Well, you know, St. Thomas More last year, it was a last second shot. The free throw on the way. Good. It's down to a one-point lead. Last year, St. Thomas More, they survived Chester in the first round.
Yes, they did.
Then it went triple overtime against Aberdeen Roncalli before they were able to handle Viberg Hurley in the championship.
Cobblers need to control the ball here.
They ran their offense perfectly about three possessions ago, killing clock and then getting the three from Lewis.
See if they go
since
to count
that time.
Uh-oh.
Offensive foul, Cody Harris,
his fourth. He got a little carried away with the elbow trying to clear space.
Mike Purcell not particularly pleased, as you can tell. And O'Gorman, who trailed it 40-34 just a minute ago, with a chance to take the lead back. They have trailed by six, they have led by seven. The pull-up jumper on the left side. Nope, the fake. Instead, Schaefauer in the lane. Good. O'Gorman back on top, seven, as they have scored seven straight.
Schaefauer was 17 in the game.
1 point over his average. Lewis into the front court. Rapid City Central, still plenty of time. Just keep playing the way that got you that lead. They'll give it up to Lewis. Schaefauer the steal. The run out. No good. The put back up and good.
Hank Lindbergh will get credited with that tip.
Riedel was there as well, but good hustle by O'Gorman hitting the offensive glass and not assuming, and then a turnover on Central. And,
Hold on,
Mike Purcell actually got the timeout first. Mike Purcell got the timeout first, and so consequently, it will stay with the Cobblers. As the ball was coming into the front court, Mike Purcell was calling the timeout. And so the Cobblers will not give up the basketball.
Here's an update. 2 minutes to go in overtime in Sioux Falls. St. Thomas More with a one-point lead over Tri-Valley.
Couple of reminders for you. As coming up on Sunday night, it will be the South Dakota High School Boys Basketball Tournament documentary, Kings of the Court. It airs this Sunday night at 8 o'clock Central, 7 o'clock Mountain on SDPB1 TV. And what a terrific documentary. Dave Kemp with much of the research on that, as well as Rena Blue a few years back. And then Chad Anderson and Kyle Moore have picked it up and run with it. And it is a terrific program. The kind of programming you only find on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. So that's Sunday at 7. I just want to make sure that my information in the graphic is the same. Is it Sunday at 7, Truck? Sunday at 7.
6 Mountain.
So 6 Mountain.
Well, Gorman, Mike, is on a 12-3 run since Central took their biggest lead at 37-31.
Remember, Central hit that that three-pointer after running their half-court offense. Lewis with the three-pointer. You see the time winding down, and there's another turnover. Rapid City Central has turned the ball over, I believe, 6 times in the quarter.
15 for the game.
Schaefauer down the lane, pull up, floater, no good. Connett kept it alive, saved by O'Gorman. And a fresh shot clock so they can eat some time with the 3-point lead.
A minute and a half to go, and the A's in overtime, tied at 60. St. Thomas More and Tri-Valley.
Working that perimeter, eating the clock. Back out to Connor Schaefauer. Again, Derek Roby, before the shot clock, was the king at killing clock. Had to adjust his ways a little bit. Now a timeout called by Coach Roby.
30 seconds to go over in the A's, Mike, still tied at 60.
There will be 11 seconds left on the shot clock for O'Gorman to make this a two-possession game.
I would expect it's either going to be Wallen or Schaefbauer who will be taking the shot. They'll set up a play for one of those two guys, maybe try to get inside to mimic.
South Dakota Public Broadcasting's crew spread across the state in Aberdeen and Sioux Falls and here in Rapid City. But next week, back on the road to Brookings as they cover the South Dakota High School All-State Band Concerts. SDPB will provide a live webcast of the concerts next Saturday. And then they'll present the concerts themselves on SDPB TV April 21st. Again, for all the information on the scheduling, archived, and more, take a look. That John Sebastian presents the Folk Rewind. That's been terrific. Kings of the Court is unbelievable. Over South Dakota, I've gotten a chance to see. If you don't know who Joe Bonamassa is, you don't know guitar players. He is unbelievable. And, of course, who couldn't forget Red Green and the B-52s. It's Festival going on now through Sunday, March 25th, right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
By the way, Tri-Valley has the ball, 26 seconds to go, all tied in overtime. They can take last shot and win it. We'll let you know what happens.
Schaefbauer gives it up on the left side. Wallen down the lane, lost the handle, got it back, had it partially blocked, but he's fouled, and he'll step to the line. Sam Wallen steps up to the free throw line. The foul is on Robert Connett. That will be his third. But a chance to make this a two-possession game. Free throw, good.
First trip to the free throw line for Wallen.
Sam on the year is a 61% free throw shooter. Checking in is Jesse Riddle for the Rapid City Central Cobblers. Connett will take a chair. Free throw, no good. Riddle gets the rebound. Nice job right off the bench. They'll give it up to Lewis. Still plenty of time for the Cobblers.
Boy, the Cobblers have not scored in a long time, Mike.
They led it 40 to 34. A 10-0 run by O'Gorman. Pull-up jumper for three. No good. Rebound. Knocked around. Riddle, I believe, was the last to touch it. It will belong to the Knights of O'Gorman.
They're going double overtime in Sioux Falls, Mike. St. Thomas More and Tri-Valley.
Back into the lineup is Lindberg and Schulten, and a timeout called by Mike Purcell.
St. Thomas More and Tri-Valley are headed into double overtime.
So O'Gorman trailed it 40 to 34. The Rapid City Central turned the ball over. O'Gorman hit their free throws, and they've now got the lead and the ball in a two-possession game with 32.9 seconds left to play. Reminder, a full weekend of activity. One of the nice things about coming to the boys' AA tournament is we get halftime entertainment at all of these games. It is really a wonderful job that they do here at the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center. Of course, alternates between the A and the AA each year. Aberdeen, the home of the Boys B tournament. At least for the foreseeable future, there's going to be some discussion on perhaps having one site for the tournaments, like so many of our states across the country do. But right now, number one is trying to hold off number eight.
Jake Lewis hit a three with just about 4 minutes to go in this final quarter. That's the last time that Central has scored.
And the foul going to be on Ryan Lees. They're going to put O'Gorman at the free throw line.
Foul's on 14, Ryan Lees.
And that is double bonus now. So Schaefbauer will step to the line. He will be shooting the double bonus. Connor, 74% free throw shooter. Got it. It was some steals, some free throws, and some turnovers that got O'Gorman the lead back. Jesse Riddle, the 6-foot sophomore, will check back in. Connett will take a chair. Connaught was such an effective part of the offense through the first 3.5 quarters of this game. Second free throw is no good, and the rebound controlled by Lease. Lease to Lewis. Lewis will give it up to Fierro. Fierro goes off to Riddle, and another turnover. And that should just about do it for the O'Gorman Knights. With 20 seconds left to play, we will see Central foul again. So O'Gorman and a timeout called by Rapid City Central. But what a performance by Central. Again, they just couldn't hold on once it got down under 4 minutes. And O'Gorman looks like they will survive. Of course, all 12 games from all three locations on SDPB 1, 2, and 3, and online at sdpb.org. If you are watching online, drop us an email. We would love to hear from you. It is always wonderful to see where folks are reconnecting with their South Dakota roots. We know many of you are watching that are serving our country, either overseas or right here in the homeland. We are glad that we can bring a taste of home to you here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. The inbound timeout called. Good defense by Rapid City Central. A full timeout called by O'Gorman as they were unable to get the ball inbounds. You know, none of these things happen on South Dakota Public Broadcasting without your support. And a great way to show your support is to become a member of the South Dakota Public Broadcasting Booster Club. You can join at sdpb.org. Your support really does make a difference. How terrific, by the way, was Antique Roadshow on Monday. The Junk in the Trunk special and the pledge breaks that were going on. Michelle Von Monen and Bob Bussey hosting that. And the response, it is very apparent that there are thousands of you across the state of South Dakota that watch and enjoy Antiques Roadshow the same way that I do. And of course, Antiques Roadshow coming here to Rapid City in July.
Cobblers need a big steal here, Mike. Otherwise, they got to force the Knights, get a quick foul, and put the Knights back on the line.
So once again, full court, man-to-man pressure. Couple of screens, but they get it to Schaefauer. Schaefauer into the front court. They're chasing him. Now they'll find him and foul him. But 5 seconds go off the clock before they're able to run down Connor Schaefauer, who steps up to the line with 18 points on the day. He will be shooting two. Good. It's a two-possession game. If he hits this one, that means that Rapid City would have the ball three times in order to score enough points in order to overcome this lead. It is a three-possession game. Rapid City Central offense headed south at the 340 mark. They have not scored since that time. Jumper for three, no good. Rebound, run down in the corner by O'Gorman, and that's going to do it. Rapid City Central led it 40-34. But it was O'Gorman who goes on the 13-0 run to end the ball game and to avoid the first round upset as the Knights survive to move into the evening session against the winner of our next game. It will be Washington versus Brookings coming up in our next battle. O'Gorman with the win. Connor Schaefauer leads the way with 20 points this afternoon. Several of them came floating into the lane, cutting into that defense against the zone. And then several more late free throws to ice this one up for the O'Gorman Knights. So again, the final, 47-40. O'Gorman led it 14-9 at the end of one after trailing 9-8. O'Gorman was on top 25-21 at halftime. It was all tied at 31 apiece at the end of three. And then O'Gorman, as we say, trailed it. They trailed it 40-34, but a 13-0 run gives O'Gorman the win. And Craig Maddock is standing by with the head coach. Craig?
Coach, it was your fourth quarter defense that was the big difference in this game.
You know, we really did a good job of just making a couple hustle plays real late, I thought. You know, it just long rebounds. We're going after them. We're getting them before they go out of bounds. And you really have to credit our guys for stepping up and making some big plays and never quitting.
Cobbler defense was pretty good today.
You know, I tell you what, the Cobblers are a good basketball team. Cannot had a great game. I thought they did a great job, good game plan. You have to credit Coach Purcell and the Rapid City Cobblers. Again, they fought hard. They did everything they could. And in fact, I was a little nervous here down the stretch. You know, we kept reminding ourselves, we kept reminding our players that, you know, there's a lot of clock left. Don't panic. We've been in this situation before and just kind of weathered the storm. But I really thought Rapid City did a great job. And like I said, they did a good job of getting the ball inside to Cannot. And he created some problems for us. But our kids weathered the storm, and we're going to move on.
See you tomorrow night.
Thanks.
Head coach Derek Roby, the Knights win it, the two-time defending champs. Move to the semifinals tomorrow night. Also, St. Thomas More in double overtime has defeated Tri-Valley. So two number one seeds advance in the boys basketball tournament. You're watching the AA Boys from Rapid City on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Dakota Bank, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Farmers Union Insurance,